I welcome you to today's session of physics. And in physics, we are discussing about chapter number 7, which is electricity and magnetism. As you all know, in our two previous lecture, we had covered out most of its topic. But unfortunately, I forget to taught you the two topics which I am going to discuss in this video. This is your lecture number 3. So what are the topics I am telling you? Let's move to the below section. We had lecture number 2 up to symbols for electrical component circuits. These things we all have had already discussed. Series and parallel circuits. Till up to parallel circuits we had covered in our lecture number 2. But unfortunately, I forget to taught you this one. From here you can see that this is an experiment which I forget to taught you, so I covered you in this lecture. Fine. So here you can see that this is the experiment which is understand the behavior of appliances of parallel circuits, how parallel circuits behave. Fine. So you will you can do this experiment, fine, and perform in your home or in laboratory. And if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. I am now moving to the this one. You can see here, in series circuits all the devices work instantly when the switch is in on. Fine. If one device stops working, all other stops working too. This is the main disadvantage of series combination. So appliances do not work for to their full capacity as the overall current within the circuit decreases. While in the parallel circuit, electrical devices are connected with common junction point. There are multiple paths through which the electric current can flow. Fine. So what happened in the parallel circuits? In parallel circuit, any device can be switched on or off without affecting the working of other devices. This is the main advantage of parallel combination. Second one, if one device stops working, all other devices continue to work. Clear? Each device gets enough electrical energy. So we will now describe how the cells are joined together to make a battery. As I told you in our two lectures, there is a combination of cells to form a battery. So when joining two or more cells to make a battery, the positive terminal of one cell is always kept in contact with the negative terminal of other cells. This thing we are discussing right now. Clear? So we know that the positive terminal of a cell is the brass cap and the negative terminal is at the bottom of the zinc container. So the cells are joined in such a way that the brass cap of one cell touches the zinc bottom of the other cell. Here you can see, this is the figure number 7.14. in this figure shows the battery made of two cells A and B. In this figure, the positive terminal, which is your brass cap of cell B, has been kept in contact with the negative terminal of the cell A, which is of zinc container. Fine. So the positive terminal of cell A and the negative terminal of cell B are free to draw current from this combination or battery of the two cells. So if, however, we combine two cells by keeping the positive terminal of one cell in contact with the positive terminal of the other cell, then the battery obtained will not work, because as I told you, both the same charges repel each other. So both the positive terminals cannot perform an electric cell. Clear? Similarly, here you can see that in this figure 7.15, these are the two figures given here. If we combine two cells by keeping the negative terminal of one cell contact with the negative terminal of other cells, even then the battery will not work. Fine. So in the above figure, we have shown that combination of only two cells form a battery. We can, however, join together any number of cells in a similar way to form a higher battery. For example, a battery made up of four cells joined together, as shown here in this figure, you can see here. We form here a larger battery by combining a multiple cells. So in a torch, the cells are placed one after the other, clear, in a straight line, as shown here in figure 7.14. So in many devices, the cells are not placed one after the other. The two cells are placed side by side also. Here you can see the side by side position which we use in remote control. For example, in a TV remote control, the two cells are placed side by side. When the two cells are placed side by side, they are joined to make a battery as shown in the above figure 7.17a. Clear? So in this case, the positive terminal of one cell cannot be in touch with the negative terminal of the other cell. So the positive terminal of one cell is joined to the negative terminal of other cells by a piece of wire. You can see here in this figure 7.17, here we join the two terminals by a piece of wire that is taking here. Clear? Actually, when two cells are joined or to be placed side by side in an appliances, then there is a special arrangement to connect the positive terminal of one cell to the negative terminal of the other cell. Inside its battery compartment, there is usually a thick wire or a metal strip in the battery compartment of the appliances which connects the positive terminal of one to the negative terminal of the other cell. So automatically when the cells are placed inside it, so moreover in order to help us to place the cells correctly in the battery compartment, the symbol plus and minus are printed in the two sides of the battery compartment. The battery compartment of an appliances to join two cells kept side by side is shown in the figure 7.17b. You can see here in this figure, this is the combination of side by side cells which we use in our remote cells. Clear? Now there is an experiment again given here. So you read this experiment and try to do yourself. If you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Clear? Now I am moving to the good and bad conductor of electricity. This is the important one. What are the good conductors and what are the bad conductors of electricity? So those materials which allows electricity or current pass through them are called conductors of electricity. So all metals are conductor of electricity. Silver metal is the best conductor of electricity. Fine. And copper and aluminium metals are good conductors. Other metals like iron, steel, mercury and gold etc. are also conductors. All the objects made of metal are also conductors. For example, the objects such as coins, keys, pins, aluminium foils, swing needles and iron nail etc. are all conductors of electricity because they are made of metals or their alloys. A non-metal called carbon in the form of graphite is also a conductor of electricity. Clear? The thin black core of our pencil is called pencil lead. Pencil lead is made up of graphite, so pencil lead is a conductor of electricity. The human body does not conduct electricity as good as metals, but still we feel shock. The human body conducts electricity to a small extent, so the human body is a poor conductor of electricity. A person gets electric shock on touching an uncovered electric wire carrying a current because the electric current passes through his body. Water also conducts electricity to a small extent, so water is also a poor conductor of electricity. If a person operates an electric switch with wet hands, he can get an electric shock because water present on the wet hand can conduct some electricity from the switch into his body. We should therefore operate the switches of electric appliances with dry hands. So those materials which do not allow electric current to pass through them are called bad conductor or insulators of electricity, like rubber, plastic, polyethylene, PVC, bakelite, wood, etc. They are all called as bad conductor of electricity. Fine. So the outer covering of electric wires is made up of plastic. As you see in your homes, the wire which we use for the for current to flow current are also insulated with some materials, plastics, because plastic is an insulator. So air is an insulator. When an electric switch is in the off position, then air is present between the ends of the wires connected to the switch. Since air is a non-conductor of electricity or insulator, so electricity is not conducted across the gaps between the ends of the wires in the switch and hence the bulb does not light up. So here you can see this, there is an experiment again given. So you have to do this experiment, and if you have any doubt, you can ask me in the comment section. Here you can see the crocodile tips, and both the clips are in open state and the bulb is not glowing. Still the current is passing from the battery. Clear? And if you see its next figure here, the clips are joined. So the circuit is completed, the crocodile clips are joined, the circuit is completed, the current from the battery reaches to the bulb and it glowing. Clear? Now here you can see that in between the two clips we put a rubber eraser. Now rubber is an insulator, so that's why the circuit is not completed and bulb is not in the on state. Or now if we talk about here, so here we stick a paper clip of steel. Now steel is a good conductor. So the circuit is completed and bulb is glowing here. So this is a simple experiment you can do by yourself. Clear? So this is the end of the chapter, students. I hope it is everything is clear for you. From this I am winding up my session. Thank you, class. Thank you very much.